Question number 14. Both citizens and foreigners. Right to elementary education. First option. Second, equality of opportunity in public matters, public employment. Is it available? It is not available. 16 is not available. So, second is out. Freedom of conscience, profession, practice, propagation of religion. Article 25. It is available to all. Freedom from payment of taxes for the promotion of any religion. If Article 25 to 28 is available to all, it means it is also available to foreigners. Thereafter, protection of language, script and culture of minorities, it is Article 29. So, that is not available. So, which are available? Your option is 1, 3 and 4. Good. Option D is correct also. Okay? Any problem? No. At question number 15. With reference to laws of citizenship, under the Citizenship Act 1955, consider the following statements. If the citizen has, within 5 years, after registration or naturalization, been imprisoned for 1 year. If the citizen has been ordinary resident of, out of India for 5 years. If a person renounces his Indian citizenship, their minor children also loses their citizenship. So, actually, this question is related with the laws of citizenship. What are the methods or reasons when an individual citizen may lose his citizenship in India? Renunciation, termination and deprivation. Three are there. Okay. So, if anyone is not residing in India, sorry, if just you just see the third option, if a person renounces his Indian citizenship, their minor children also loses their citizenship, definitely it should be correct. Okay? Because minors cannot decide what they should do, what they should not. It is a law. Okay? Second. Now, come to this second option. Yes, I am just going to that. If the citizen has been ordinary resident of out of India for 5 years, actually what happens when you get Indian citizenship? Thereafter, if you get Indian citizenship through naturalization or registration, and after that you went back somewhere else or went back to your country where you were residing and from where you came to India and took the citizenship, then if you will reside there permanently 7 years, then your citizenship will be permanent. Okay? 7 years. Here kya hai? Has been imprisoned for hereafter and within 5 years after registration or naturalization being imprisoned. Okay? Not for 1 year. It is written for 1 year. It is not for 1 year, but it is for 2 years. Imprisoned for 2 years, then he will be deprived from his citizenship. So, answer, correct answer is B. Only 3 is the correct answer. Question number 16. Which of the following statements are correct regarding fundamental rights? Option first, they protect the liberties and freedoms of the people against the invasion by the state. They are absolute but not qualified in nature. Wrong. They are available against the arbitrary action of state and private individuals also. Okay, correct. So, 1 and 3. Option is C. Okay. Actually, fundamental rights are in the nature that no one can, neither the state nor any private individual can encroach your fundamental rights. They are in that nature actually. No one can do that. Okay. Question number 17. The Union of India includes which of the following? States, union territories, territories acquired by Government of India at any future time. There are three options and what are the correct answers? Article 1. What article says? India, that is Bharat, is a union of states. And my dear friends, always remember that in the expression union of states, union territories are not included. Union territories are not included. Only the states are not included. Okay, first thing. Second thing, second important thing, when you say union of states, okay, and the question is Union of India includes which of the following? So Union of India includes states only. Why? It is in future, isn't so? Well, it is in future that whether India will acquire any territory, then whether India will make that territory a union or a particular state, or will include that territory into a state. Remember? So, Union of India is having states only. It is not necessary. For example, when there was a treaty or agreement between India and Bangladesh related with some villages are included in India and some Indian villages were included in, given to Bangladesh. Okay? Land border treaty. Now, those who were included in India, they are only included as the resident of the West Bengal state of India, isn't it? So now no any state is created, though some territory is also came with them into India, included with them into India. That's why you cannot say that future territory should also be included, okay? Clear, hey? That will be in future, and in future anything will be included as the state, then that will come under the state. Why? Very precisely, always remember, union territories are not included. Okay. Next question. So answer is A option, only one. Indian constitution is a combination of federal and non-federal features. Point out non-federal features. All India services. So the member of, first option is All India services. So members of the All India services are recruited by central government. Who can terminate them finally? Central government means the president of India. So, is it, and when they are being recruited, they are sent and appoint and to be appointed in states. So, the power is in the hands of center. That's why it will be non-federal means unitary. Second, flexibility of the constitution. Flexibility of the constitution. Flexibility of the constitution makes what? Flexibility of the constitution ensures that any time when parliament wants to make any change, can change. So what happens? The constitutional provisions are to be changed, if are to be changed, then can be changed by the center. The power went to the, so it will be non-federal. Okay. Next option, supremacy of the constitution, it is federal. Bicameralism, it is also federal. Non-federal features are India services and flexibility of the constitution, while supremacy and bicameralism is federal feature. That's why in 18 number question, your options are 1 and 2. It means option A is correct. Okay? Which of the following statement is correct? Question number 19. Which of the following statements is correct regarding Article 22? Okay. Question number 19. Regarding Article 22, protection against arrest and detention. See, this first option is the safeguards given in the first part of Article 22 are available to an alien or a person arrested or detained under a preventive detention law. Always remember that Article 22's protection, okay, in case of arrest and detention is not available in preventive detention laws. If anyone is arrested under any preventive detention law, then Article 22 is not applicable. Okay? So the option A, gone. Second, option B, the first part of Article 22 do cover arrest under the court or under the orders of a court, civil arrest, arrest on failure to pay the income tax and deportation of an alien. So always remember, when any court has directed, then again it is not going to be applied. The protection against arrest and detention is not applied in case of the arrest on the basis of the order of the court. So option B is also incorrect, though others are. Civil arrest, arrest on failure to pay the income tax and deportation of an alien, all these are there, but arrest on the basis of the order of the court, then again the protections are not there. That Article 22 doesn't cover. The second option, option B, the first part of Article 22 do cover arrest under the orders of a court, civil arrest, arrest on failure to pay the income tax and deportation of an alien. So actually, this is also not covered under Article 22. Means these are not covered. Means the protection is basically, if we say, then is available only in case of the arrest by the police authorities after making a complaint by someone else against anyone else. Okay? The third, the protection, C option, the protection given to a person in second part of the 22 is available to only Indian citizen, not to aliens. Actually, this is also incorrect, as we know that. Okay? There are 5 articles which are not available to aliens, 22 is available to aliens. So, all these options are incorrect. Is that clear? If any doubt is in your mind, you can ask. Clear hai, Aditya? Okay. Question number 20. Which of the following is the socialistic principles derived directive principle of state policy? Now, this question is asking only the socialistic principles. Okay? And the first option is to secure a living wage, a decent standard living, and social and cultural opportunities for all workers. Okay, yes, it is good. If it is, then it is socialistic. Why? Just because of the reason that workers are also being provided the things which they need as a human being and which should be provided naturally to them. Okay? This is good. It is social justice. It is socialistic principle. Second, to organize agriculture and animal husbandry on modern and scientific lines. It is not social justice. Okay? It is liberal intellectual principle. Liberal means this principle is based on the Western liberal principle. Option number 3, to provide early childhood care and education for children until they attain the age of 6 years. The third option, to provide early childhood care, is also liberal principle. That's why only first one is the socialistic principle, and which is to secure a living wage, a decent standard of living, and social and cultural opportunities for all workers. So option A is correct in question number 20. 21. Which of the following best describes the concept of equal protection of laws? Equal protection of laws. You just see the concept of equal protection of laws. Equal protection of laws. It is based upon the maxim of Aristotle, and he said equality exists among equals only. Similarly, equality cannot exist among unequals. Similarly, any effort of equality among unequals shall result in inequality. Okay? So, equal protection of the laws basically says equality of treatment in equals, in equal situations. What? Equality of treatment in equal conditions, equal situations, or among equals. For example, suppose if any law is being passed for the women. So, all the women will be considered equal in the context of that law. But that law will not be provided to the men. Clear? The difference is only this, in between equal protection of the laws and equality before the laws. Equality before the laws means everyone should be treated equal before the law. But here, the law can be used discriminately, but all those who are equal should be treated equal. Okay? Clear hai? Got that? So, ab jara sa padh lo isko. The equal subjection of all persons to the ordinary law of the land administered by ordinary law courts, whether it will be true or not. Kya bolte hain? No, it will never be true. Why? Just because of the reason that it is related with the equality before the law concept. Okay? Second option, B option, the equality of treatment under equal circumstances, both in the privileges conferred and liabilities imposed by the law. This is only I was telling you, the equality among equal conditions, situations or circumstances, not unequal. Option C, no person is above the law, is the related concept of rule of law. Fourth, the absence of any special privileges in favor of any person, it is also the inherent condition of equality before the law or the rule of law. Okay? So, which option is correct? Option B is correct of 21 question number. Okay? Yeah, hey Aditya. Hello, don't do this. Question number 22. Through different constitutional amendment acts, some new directive principles added in the original list. Which of the following are now in the original list? We know that by the 42nd Amendment Act, there were some new directives were added, as well as by the 97th Amendment Act, some were added. So, in the question 22, the first one is to protect and improve the environment and to safeguard forest and wildlife. Okay, it has been added finally later by the good. Actually, Article 48 was added by the Constitutional Amendment Act in 1976, which is 42nd Amendment Act of the Constitution. Okay? So, the safeguard forest and wildlife has been added by 42nd Amendment Act 1976. To make provision for just and humane conditions for work and maternity relief, it is already given, it was already given, no need to amend. To secure a living wage, a decent standard life was already given, the option third was also given already. To secure a living wage, a decent standard of life and social and cultural opportunities for all workers, it was already given. 43 is the article number. And for the maternity relief, 42nd article number, article 42, article 43. Means, second option is given in under article 42, third option is given under article 43. That's why they were already given, no need to any amendment. Next, the fourth one, to promote voluntary formation, autonomous functioning, democratic control and professional management of cooperative society, it was added by 97th as the part of article 43, 43b, that's why it is correct. So, 1 and 4 is correct. So, option A is correct option. Okay? Now, Question number 23. According to the Article 12, the states include which of the following? Article 12 defines the state for the purpose of fundamental rights. Article 12 defines the states for the purpose of fundamental rights are part 3 of the Constitution, and it includes the center, means the government and parliament of India, all local authorities, municipalities, panchayat, district boards, etc. And the third option which is given here, judiciary. Okay? Judiciary is not given there. Okay? Judiciary is not included there. So, first and second both are correct. So, option B is correct. Judiciary can never be added for that purpose, na? Because judiciary is going to protect the fundamental rights. It is independent in India, na? It is independent. Okay? Question number 24. Consider the following statements. Fundamental rights are societarian and socialistic, while the PSPs are personal and individualistic in nature. It is vice versa actually. It is wrongly depicted, wrongly mentioned. Fundamental rights are personal and individualistic, while the PSPs are socialistic and societarian. Second option. Fundamental rights are negative as they prohibit the state from doing certain things, while DPSPs are positive as they require the state to do certain things. Yes, the second is correct. So option B is correct in question number 24. Question number 25. In the Indian context, which of the following initiatives, programs, laws are formulated by government in order to implement the DPSPs? Good question. So, MG Narega, is it true? Good. MG Narega is going to provide the employment, na? And the DPSPs energizes that everyone should get the opportunity to work. Okay? In fact, it supports both the article, Article 41 and Article 43. MG Narega supports both the article, Article 41 and 43. Three-tier Panchayat Raj system means Gandhian Gram Swaraj concept is, okay, it is also, thereafter, third option, Equal Remuneration Act 1976, equal pay for equal work is the principle, okay, it is also, fourth, ancient and historical monuments and archaeological sites, and Remains Act 1951, it is the duty, in fact, it is also given that the state shall protect historical monuments and archaeological sites, so it is also under DPSP, so all the four are correct. Option is D. Any doubt? No doubt. Very good. This is national importance places, na? Article 49. Okay? So, to implement that, it has been enacted. Okay? Now, the question number 26. Who is the guardian of fundamental rights enumerated in Indian Constitution? Who is? Supreme Court of India. 27. Consider the following statements about fundamental rights. Fundamental rights are not absolute but qualified. Good. Correct answer. All the fundamental rights are suspended during national emergency. Wrong. All nine, eh? Good. Very good. So, which one is not going to be suspended? Okay? Article 21 is. And what about 20? Protection against hereditary detention? Good. Okay? So, only option 1 is correct. That's why option A is correct. Isn't so? Next question. Which of the following are the fundamental duties under Article 51A? So, make it corrected. You must mug up all the fundamental duties. Well, but when it is considered that how to remember it, so just whenever you are mugging up, relate it with something, then only you will remember. So, question number 28. Duty to pay taxes is given under duties, fundamental duties. What do you think? Never ever. Okay? It is not given. 1. To protect and improve the natural environment including forests, lakes, rivers and wildlife. It is given under the fundamental duties. Duty to pay taxes, not given under the fundamental duties. To value and preserve rich heritage of the country's composite culture. It is also given to vote in public elections. Yeah. So, 1 and 3 is correct. Correct option is C. With regard to the procedure for the amendment of the Constitution, as laid down in Article 368, which of the following statements are correct? Correct. The bill can be introduced only by a minister and does require permission, prior permission of the president. Is it required? No. Wrong option. If the bill seeks to amend the federal provision of the Constitution, it must also be ratified by the legislature of every state by a simple majority, by the every state or by only 50% of the states. Good. So, it is also incorrect. Next option. The president can withhold his assent to the bill or return the bill for the reconsideration of the parliament. Can president do anything with the constitutional amendment bills except to accept that? Means accept to permit that. Accept to give his assent. Can he do anything? No, never ever. Constitutional amendment bill has to be passed by him, assented by the president. That's why no option is correct in this question. So, answer is D. 29 D. 30th question. As per the Indian Constitution, which of the following provisions can be amended by simple majority of parliament? So, simple majority means the operational majority. Okay? Elections to parliament and the state legislature, yes, can be done. Abolition or creation of legislative councils in the states, yes. No, kata hi nahi. No, by the simple majority. Third, representation of states in the parliament. Not possible by simple majority. Special majority. Rules of procedure in parliament. Yes, easily. Simple majority. So, abhi tak kaun kaun mila? 1, 2 and 4. Next is conferment of more jurisdiction on the Supreme Court. It can also be done by the simple majority. That's why. Option is 1, 2, 4 and 5. Correct option is C. Next question. 31. Question number 31. Which of the following statement is incorrect? The state can make any provision for the reservation of appointments or posts in favor of any backward class. Second, Parliament can prescribe residence as a condition for certain employment or appointment in a state or local authority or other authority. Is it correct? Article 16 hai ye, okay? Article 16. Article 16b or Article 16.2 provides the first option. Option A, backward class reservation, 16b. And again, the B option, Parliament can prescribe residence as a condition for certain employment or appointment in the state. Is that or the local authority? 16a. Next question, next option is A. Option C. A person shall be liable to any civil or criminal proceedings in any court in respect of the publication in a newspaper of a substantially true report of any proceeding of either House of Parliament or the House of the Legislature of a state. Galat hai. True report? No. The foreign, though there is an other issue involving that the publication is basically on the permission, on the basis of the permission of the house. Okay? That is another issue. But if the true report is being published, then why anyone will be punished? Okay? No one will be punished.